golem. Fly. Up, up and away, web. Shazam. Go, 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 web, go.
Let me ask you a question. What do you think it feels like to have superpowers? Does it feel like this? Or this? Or this? If you've never used one of these devices, you may be inclined to say yes. But let me tell you, the answer is no. Is 2004.
The Spider-Man triple action web blast. Pop in the web blaster and shoot tons of crime-busting web. Loads of web blast in action for maximum satisfaction.
This toy has certainly made the rounds with many of you in your youth, I'm sure. As cool as it felt to shoot silly string pretending to be Spider-Man, this toy had one glaring issue. The trigger. I mean, what a cumbersome way to activate your superpowers. These lever triggers are now omnipresent, and they really haven't moved beyond this extremely infantile design. And look, I'm no angel here either. Years ago, I spent a considerable amount of time with solenoid valve web shooters for the sole reason that they can be electronically actuated, just to eliminate this trigger system. But as I've detailed in one of my must-watch videos, solenoid valves are not good for web shooters for a myriad of reasons. Their geometry restricts flow, especially for more viscous fluids. The dead zones in the geometry where the velocity of the fluid reaches zero leave solidified webbing that either clogs the valve or stops it from closing. Web fluid has ruined several of these valves for me. This was a consistent problem until the Human Spider and I began work on a new kind of valve, a specialized one, designed around the idea of web shooters shooting web fluid. Better than the ordinary aerosol valves you'd find on a silly string can, and definitely better than solenoid valves. I've detailed my further improvements of this valve using principles of viscous fluid dynamics in this video, which you should definitely watch. Click the card, up there, do it. So what's the problem? This valve is optimized, or at the least, a lot closer to optimized than the Human Spider's original design. Why am I making this video? Well, just like most of the web shooters you'll see people make, just like the lighter web shooters, the atomizer web shooters, even these cardboard web shooters, and yes, this dumb toy, this valve requires a mechanical activation. And look, it's not a bad thing. All of these people and myself have used mechanical activation for one reason alone. It's easy. Not easy to use, no, but easy to build, easy to implement. And because this hasn't really been a problem worth solving, most people are focusing on increasing the strength of the web fluid or just keep making different but equivalent designs, which is fine, but for me, now, it is a problem worth solving. So back to the question, what does it feel like to have superpowers? Let's go back to 2002 Spider-Man, which I so eloquently parodied just a few minutes ago. It's quite simple, really. Tobey Maguire goes like this, and web comes out. He goes like this, and web comes out. Not like this, this, or this, like this, and web comes out. He goes like this, and well, it only works sometimes. But barring any existential crisis stuff, I don't really want to get into it, he has complete control over the process. No malfunction, no environmental interference. And look, all the other Spideys with non-biological web shooters have those malfunctions and those interferences, but only when it's convenient for the story. All other times, there really is no difference between the behavior we see from Toby's web shooters and Andrew and Tom's web shooters. The web shooter devices act as though they are part of the wearer's body. And I figure, you know, that's what we should be trying to replicate. I want to go like this, and web comes out. Which means, these lever triggers, no thank you, no thank you. They are especially a nightmare if you plan to couple your web shooting activities with parkour. So what have I done to solve this problem? Originally, I wanted to stick to mechanical triggers. Now try to forget as you watch this segment that this eventually is going to fail, because I think the work I did here was pretty interesting. Mechanical triggers have their benefits. No electricity required, which means no power supply. You can directly control the amount that the valve is open, too. Coming up with a mechanical trigger to do exactly what I want is going to be complicated. Remember, Tobey Maguire, my personal friend.
Please don't say that.
He goes like this, and Webb comes out. Not like this, this, or this. Only this. Index up, middle down, ring down, and pinky up. I love you in sign language. This is a specific pattern with ups and downs for four fingers. You know what this looks like to me? Binary. 0110. A specific 4-bit number input that triggers a firing signal, a 1 output. Mechanical digital logic is super fascinating. I took to YouTube to get some inspiration for mechanisms that could be used as logic gates. There I found everything from Lego creations to fully 3D printed designs. Coming up with a mechanical logic gate that serves my specific purpose was tough. And in a lot of ways, I had to start from scratch. I went through many, many designs, eventually settling on some variation of this. At its center, a mechanical AND gate, which ensures that both the middle and ring finger need to be flexed to transmit force to the output. I got the idea for an AND gate like this from this 2013 YouTube video by this guy. There are some other interesting designs, like this one, which I did not come up with, but I can't find the source anymore, so please someone let me know if you find it, and I'll credit the inventor. I did make a cool calculator for it that all of you can use to design your own variations. Check the description for that. I figured this design was easier to chain to other gates, because the speed of one or both of the inputs is the same as the speed of the output, meaning the same amount of force is transmitted as well. Then it was just a matter of ensuring that flexing the index finger or the pinky finger decoupled the output of the AND gate from the output of the whole trigger. So I came up with these teeth that remain in place, coupling the outputs, but are pulled away by flexing both fingers. I added this linkage to couple the teeth from the outer fingers together so that one of the fingers flexing would move both teeth, meaning both the pinky and the index finger have to be extended for the trigger to work. One cool feature of these mechanisms is my use of multi-layer flexure mechanisms, which can be printed in a single part, allowing for almost frictionless pivot joints within very small mechanisms. I found that using one jointed layer of soft thermoplastic polyurethane topped with a links-only layer of hard thermoplastic polyurethane was a great way to have both flexible and rigid sections in a single small part, without the use of multiple extruders, as the material can simply be switched out halfway through printing. I'd highly recommend this technique for anyone developing small mechanisms. This design works pretty well, even if it does have some slop from the imprecise manufacturing of FDM 3D printing. This could easily be cleaned up by the better machines I plan on purchasing for Dragline Dynamics, which is the nonprofit laboratory I'm starting in the fall, where I and others will be working on solutions to make web shooters and other gadgets better than ever. Mounting this trigger on my hand, we can see how it's supposed to work. The output is only actuated by the desired Spidey hand configuration. I will say from wearing it, I was not a fan of the forces my fingers had to exert. It didn't feel as comfortable as I would like a trigger to be. And I realized there was a big variable I was not accounting for, the wrist. Even if I get the mechanism on my hand to pull the output cable the correct distance to actuate the valve, the bending of the wrist will change the position of the output, adding a very large amplitude of disturbance to the output, which I can't compensate for. A trigger like this is pretty much unusable then, even if it was a cool project.
We have problems. When people have problems, they work it out. They talk to each other.
Don't try to persuade me. Don't do that. Because, I mean, like, I understand you're a big fan. And I'm honored because you're, like, the second best Spider-Man.
Now, do I think a trigger like this is impossible to build to perfection? No, absolutely not. I think it could be expertly designed and built. But I can't do that on my own or with my current technology. So if you'd like to see this perfected, please support me on Patreon so that I can elevate this project to levels of efficacy only seen by Toby's organic web shooters. For now, I elected to bite the bullet and solve this problem using an electronic trigger. So I developed this glove, where the bending of each finger is an input to a microcontroller, which I've programmed to output a high signal given the desired input. This glove is actually multimodal, meaning it has multiple types of sensing as an input. Multimodal systems typically have a better time discerning reality. I mean, if human beings only had a sense of smell, it'd be a tough world. Aside from sensing finger flexion, I have also included your typical pressure sensor in the palm of the glove. Basically, how this glove operates is it enters a calibration mode upon being powered on, which means you now get to decide what hand position you want to trigger your web shooter. It works best if you limit your hand position to a binary flexing versus extending fingers, as that's easier for the sensor to discern than anything in between. So let's say I want to use the typical Spidey hand signal to trigger my webbing. In calibration mode, I press my two middle fingers to the palm, applying pressure to the sensor in the palm. While there is pressure on the palm, the microcontroller records the positions of all of the fingers so that it remembers your desired hand position. Then, the calibration mode is automatically exited once the palm is released. Now you're in the trigger mode. Make a fist, point, slap the palm, nothing happens, but return to your desired hand position and the trigger outputs a high signal, telling the web shooter to fire. It honestly feels like magic, if I do say so myself. I'm sure some of you are probably asking how the bending of the fingers is sensed. Well, I gotta keep some secrets. But I've had a fun time getting guesses from people on Instagram. If you can discern my exact method for extracting an electrical signal from a finger bend, I'll let you know if you're right. I'll give you a hint. It involves both materials and a fundamental law of nature. I'm pretty proud of it. So put your guesses in the comments below, and no, I'm not giving any more hints. I think there's really a lot of room for improvement with web shooter triggers, and I think one of the directions we could take Dragline Dynamics is researching how to have no trigger at all. I'm talking about the interpretation of signals that can be derived by the human body. EMG, pressure, color changes, maybe even EEG. All of these sensors in a multimodal system could do really well in discerning exactly what you intend the web shooter to do. This will truly be a superpower, as it can be reduced to essentially controlling the firing with your mind. That's possibly a year or so away, but it's not that hard to imagine a small device hidden in the wristband accomplishing all of that. Then, and only then, will the hand be truly unencumbered. If you want to support a project like this, please support Dragline Dynamics by donating to my Patreon, the link for which is in the description below, or buying some of my merch on my Spreadshirt shop, which you can find on the store tab on my channel. This will help me get my start in developing the projects that will eventually financially support the laboratory research and development. I'm doing my best to keep costs down, but all of this stuff really adds up. It's all for the greater good, so help us out. Stay safe, stay amazing, and I'll see you in the next- Hold on. I'm missing a key point here. Of course, the output of an electrical signal means that the web shooter valve will have to be electronically activated as well. Meaning, we will need some kind of mechatronic system. This is sort of like power steering for web shooters. Instead of generating the mechanical force yourself, you exert a much lower force on a mechanism that converts your force into an electrical signal, which is then read by a system that controls a much higher force output. Not to worry, I've already tackled this problem with my advanced web shooter prototype, which also solves other crucial issues that anyone who has ever used a fluid web shooter has certainly encountered before. This is the first of its kind, and I think Tony Stark would be proud of this one. If you're following me on Instagram at the.amazing.labs, you know I've been working hard on this. I'll be coming out with a short video showcase for this soon, followed by a detailed breakdown of the many, many, many systems inside of this bad boy. It's the other piece of the super fascinating puzzle that this trigger glove has helped to solve. Stay tuned for that. It's going to be amazing. I'll see you in the next one.